journey. Let's leave your career for a bit now and go a little personal now. I found out that you got married at 22.
What was pursuing you? What was the
problem? Why did you get married? I mean,
I knew.
There people who get married that early and it's fine, but I'm just like, why so early? Okay, was there a reason why?
No, my mom wanted me to.
Okay.
Yes, because my mom also, my dad got married at about the same age.
Okay.
His first child at 23. So, and I'm very close to my mom, and my mom wanted me to do that. Maybe she felt if I did that at that time, it would help me to concentrate more since I was going into the industry.
Did it?
I think so.
You're not sure.
I think so. Because right now, believe me, I have a lot of female fans. A lot of female fans. And a lot of them are like, oh my God, Yule's voice. Can I send me all sorts of messages? I thank God I'm married. I'll always look back and say, okay, I need to go back home. You know, I think it helped.
Yeah. Do you ever wonder though if maybe you should have waited a little? Are there times where you wonder maybe? Because I mean, 22. I'm not to say anything about your marriage or anything. I'm just like, 22 is pretty early.
Yeah.
Do you feel like maybe you could have lived a little more?
Then, I'll be honest. I felt that way at that time, but I don't feel that way right now. It's one of the best things I ever did for myself, and God bless my mom. Believe me, God bless my parents. I appreciate it. My daughter is 13. She's almost my height. So anytime I look at her, I came back home and I was like, when did you get this gig? You know. So it's the best thing one of the best things I ever did for myself.
Are you gonna want them to get married at your age as well?
Yeah, of course.
Would you make them get married that young?
I wouldn't say make them. I can suggest. Okay, I can advise. If they don't take it, I'll be like, okay, I did it, so I can tell you this is nice. If you don't take it, fine.
Yeah. You talk about female fans there, because I mean, you obviously would be getting a lot of that. You're famous.
A whole lot. Just like you.
How does that get handled, especially with your wife as well? Do you guys laugh about it? Do you respond sometimes, maybe? Jokingly, if I can save you with that.
I don't respond. I need to keep it under, you know, that level where it should be.
Yeah.
You know, and my wife understands, because maybe at that time when I started, it was a problem because she was getting used to it, to adjust to the fact that all of a sudden this guy is everywhere, everybody loves him. But I've been there for quite a while.
Yes.
It's been a lot of time now. So I think, and then she trusts me as well. You know, which is
trust is very key.
Very, not so easy to build.
Yeah. Before we get into the career part of things, I'll talk politics again. Are you happy with the field of candidates we've seen so far, especially with the presidency? We hear about 60 of them who are running for president, give or take.
Yeah.
Are you happy with the field of candidates? Do you think there are too many?
I don't think so. You can't stop anybody from wanting to run for, you know, if you believe you've got what it takes to bring the kind of change, that true change that we want. Yeah, you won't stop anybody.
Yeah.
But again, by the time you get into politics, you realize that it's not just about a candidate, it's also about the party.
Okay.
Candidate, party, you put these two things together and then you're likely to go somewhere. Yeah. So maybe I'll not go that deep into that, but it's not just about the candidate, the candidate party. But I wish them the very best.
Yeah, well, I'm still waiting for a lot of their manifestos and campaign promises to come. I don't know, are you about the All Progressives Grand Alliance now? So I know that there's no presidential candidate, I believe, for the APGA, is there? But I know that usually, at least in the last couple of elections, there's been alignments with certain parties, deals have been struck. Are those conversations happening with APGA?
I don't know. At the moment, I don't know. Maybe I'll find out and let you know.
But most likely it will.
I don't know.
Okay, let's talk about acting now. I don't know. Are there projects we should be looking out for? Because you seem to be very busy now with politics. Are you still acting?
Yeah. Yes. I just finished. There's this movie I did. I directed, because I direct as well.
Okay.
I don't produce. I have my production company does that, but I direct. Yeah, there's this one I just finished, Native Girl. The trailer is everywhere right now, and I believe it's doing so well to be out soon. And I'm still going to do a lot more. I enjoy directing right now because it gives me the opportunity to work with other people, younger artists, and teach them everything I know. So
yeah,
a whole lot. I'm working on a lot. Yeah.
I know Nollywood is humongous. The Hausa movie industry, which is doing amazing. They churn out movies almost by the minute.
Yeah.
The Yoruba industry as well is unbelievable. People say the Igbo side of things isn't as prolific as these other ones. Do you agree, and do you feel like there's a burden on some of you to do better with that?
Yes. It's not doing as well as it should be. no disrespect to the Igbos. I'm an Igbo man, you know. But there's this thing about the Igbos, their own thing. They find, you know, embracing theirs is really is always a problem for them. They prefer embracing, you know, things from outside. So I think that's part of the issues that we're having. And it's also a burden on people like me, because I do my, once you call me to do an Igbo movie, believe me, I try to do as all that I can do to make sure we do that. And that's why I was dressed like this. You see this? I mean, I'm a culture ambassador. I'm an ambassador for the Igbos. I always dress like this. The point is, I'm trying to let them know, if I can be successful as an Igbo man and still uphold my culture, my language, everything, then it can happen to any other person. The Igbos always do that. Embracing their own is a problem. They'll rather drop theirs and embrace, you know. So I think that's part of why it's not the Nollywood, Igbo part of, you know, Nollywood is not doing so well. But a lot can be done. I have about 3 scripts right now that I'm going to produce in Igbo, and I encourage other people. I encourage even the consumers to also patronize and of course invest in it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because I mean, I know that I mean, there's Igbo movies definitely, but I always hear that most times the Igbo quote unquote directors want to do English movies because they feel like it appeals more to a bigger market as against an Igbo movie that's a smaller market. That's, you know. But isn't that also a great business decision, you think? Why not sell to a wider audience?
Yes, it's nice. It's not all about making money all the time. Yes, money should be made fine, but you know, we should also promote our culture, who we are. This is who we are. You can't change it, you know. And it's not all about money.
Yeah.
So I agree, money should be made, but at the same time, we should do as much as we can to promote what we have and who we are.
Before we go now quickly, how's your father doing? The great Peter Doshi.
The great man is fine.
How's it around him these days?
It's wonderful. You know, it's wonderful. He's always been a very strict father, strict Catholic father. Raised us very well. We're six of us. I'm the last. Actually, very, very strict man. Wonderful man to be with. Believe me, the image people see on screen is very different.
Those proverbs that he's become legendary for, does he throw them around cock that crows in the morning?
A lot of people just write those things, and because he's been known for proverbs, they put his name. But he talks like that as well.
Yeah.
But he's a wonderful person to be with. Believe me, if you spend time with him, you wouldn't want to leave him.
I can imagine. Well, our regards to him.
Good. Thank you.
And thanks a lot for being here today. All the best with everything you do.
Thank you so much.
Come back again.
Thank you so much.
Well, like I always say, you can follow the conversation on Twitter. YNigerTV is the handle. The hashtag to follow is Rubbing Minds. You can also visit the website, YNiger.tv. Thanks for joining us. I'll see you next time.